If you're a programmer, how many times a day do you do this? Select an expression, console log, a string that represents it so you can easily find it in the logs, and then the expression itself. I probably did this hundreds of thousands of times in my life, and I want to make it quicker by creating and saving a Neovim macro. I want the macro to log the current visual selection, so let's select this expression in the parentheses, for example, and start recording a macro into the L register by hitting QL. Next, we need to carefully perform the desired sequence. In this case, yank the selection, go to insert mode and the next line, type the console log function call, and I want to log the expression as a string first so I can easily identify it in the logs, and then log the expression itself to get the value. That was the whole sequence, so we hit Q to finish recording the macro, and now we can test it out. Select the expression, press @L to trigger the macro, and it plays back the sequence of keys that we just recorded. If we take a look at the registers, we can find the one we just created. Now, ideally this macro should be part of our Neovim configuration, so let's yank this line so we can paste it into our config file in a second. Okay, close window, close Vim, and here you see that I'm in my Neovim config directory, so let's open init.lua. We're gonna store our custom macros here. I'll paste the macro and make a small header at the top just to visually separate macros from the rest of the config. And now what we need to do is call a Vim function named setRegister. Register name is the letter L for log, and the value is our key sequence enclosed in double quotes. Now, you might have noticed that Vim represents our escape key with a caret followed by an open square bracket. This isn't going to work like we intended, because when replaying this macro, Vim will insert the actual caret and open bracket keys, rather than interpreting it as the escape key. A clean fix for this is replacing the caret bracket with a variable concatenation. The variable ESC stands for the escape key, of course, and we need to define it above. We say local ESC equals vim.api.nvim replace terminal codes. The first argument is our escape key string, and we need to set the rest of the arguments to boolean true. And that's how we get our escape key to work in our macro. Okay, now let's give it a spin, but before doing so, I'm gonna remove the shada file so we can start with a clean Neovim state. And then I'll open the test.js file. In the registers window, we see that we're starting clean and that our macro is loaded from config. Let's finally test it out. I'll visually select this expression in parentheses, and while still in visual mode, pressing @L logs the selection as expected. Let's try it a couple more times. And it works as intended. If you specifically want to load this macro for JavaScript files, this is how you can do it. Just set the register inside this callback function. Let's see if it works. Delete the shared data file again. And if we open a .sh file, for example, we see that the macro is not loaded. But if we open a file with a TypeScript file extension, for example, we can see that the macro is there. Same for files with the JS extension. Cool. That's it. Hope this was useful. Like, share, subscribe, and see you in the next one.